This book sold over 1 million copies worldwide, and Sir Chris Hoy calls it the mind management program that helped me win my Olympic golds. Let me show you how and why this book can help you in your day to day. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Mike. I'm a GP in Manchester, UK, and I'm also a university tutor at one of the medical schools nearby. And in this short video, I'm going to share with you the top three life lessons from Prof. Steve Peters' The Chimp Paradox. Finally, if you stick around to the end, I'll give you another great read recommendation, so let's get started. I first came across The Chimp Paradox while reviewing a patient's notes. She was mid-30s, public sector job, and the presenting complaint was anxiety. Management included discussion around antidepressants, counseling, safety netting, the usual really. But then, three words that I didn't recognize. Read chimp paradox. And then I saw it again. Different patient, same treating clinician. Read chimp paradox. When I saw it a third time, I just couldn't resist. I ran out of the consultation room, found the doctor in question, and asked her, what is the chimp paradox? And she told me it's a book. It's a mind management program. I asked her if she read it, and she said, God, no, I couldn't get through the first few pages. The best thing about the chimp paradox is that it is literally a gold mine with hundreds upon hundreds of nuggets of pure wisdom crammed into one book. And the worst thing about the chimp paradox is that it is literally a gold mine with hundreds upon hundreds of nuggets of pure wisdom crammed into one book. But here's a completely arbitrary top three. Tip number one, define your troop. Prof. Peters imagines that everyone comprises a chimp, which is an emotional, irrational, instinct-driven entity, and a human, who is calm, composed, and rational. Most mental illnesses or difficulties will come from the chimp, or more precisely by not managing the chimp. A chimp is a social animal, and it needs to feel valued and accepted by the troop of chimps that surround him or her. And what Prof. Peters proposes is that we should deliberately set time aside to define our troop, so the people around us. Cut ties with people that may be toxic to us, that put us down, that don't believe in us, regardless of how long you've known them for. Instead, invest your time, love, and energy in people that will value you in return and that will make you happy through their own positivity. Make a conscious effort to spend time with those people to strengthen those bonds, and that will put your chimp at ease. Number two, distract your chimp. I can't help shaking the analogy that the chimp is somewhat like a young child ready to wreak havoc if its needs aren't satisfied. Prof. Peters gives two suggestions of activities that will most easily distract your chimp. And if your first thought was iPad, Bob, shame on you. Music and books. Paper versions, of course. It is something that we so often forget, but listening to calm and relaxing music or reading a good book really does settle both adults and children. Now, top tip number three, the million pound question. The second half of the book concentrates on how to effectively pursue one's dreams, no matter how big or how small. He talks about how to plan, how to foresee and tackle obstacles, how to deal with failure or perceived failure that will actually sometimes lead to success, and how to stay motivated. And that's where the million pound question comes into play. It's pretty simple. If there's a task that needs completing to help you achieve your dream, but let's say you're having a duvet day, ask yourself, if someone was to give you £1 million to complete this task, would you do it? And if the answer is yes, well, get off your backside and just get it done. Finally, I promised you a bonus at the end. If you manage to placate your chimp to get through the whole book, then here's a real treat for the geek in every one of us called Ready Player One. I couldn't put this book down, and this was a recommendation from the amazing Dr. Ali Abdel, so enjoy. Right, that's it guys. I hope that was informative. If you did find that useful, give me a thumbs up, like this video, and you can leave a comment below. If you'd like to see more videos like these, please subscribe, and you can also email me directly. Otherwise, good luck.